Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Age 2. In the last episode we talked to a bunch of people and seduced Isabella and then went to the Canary and got the gunpowder poison quest. And so now basically we want to tie up a few loose ends before we head out and do some quests. And so first thing I was going to do is go home and pick up some inventory items that I have actually purchased through the download of content. Before we do that, something happens when I go home, and so in order to record it, I haven't actually gone home yet, and yeah, so let's watch what happens.
So, this is where you live. Oh, baby. Not bad. I preferred the old place. It had, more charm.
You're talking about the shack I shared with my mother, uncle, and sister.
I meant Lowtown. Dirty, chaotic, glorious Lowtown. The smell of tar, and the sea, and the sound of some whore plying her trade in a back alley. Oh. Don't you miss that?
You can get your thrills in Hightown if you know where to look.
Oh. And where would that be?
Ahem.
I can show you what I have in mind.
Oh, Nelly. This gotta hurt with all that armor on.
I should go. That was an interesting diversion.
What?
Is that all I am to you? Oh, my wounded heart.
We were using each other, sweet thing. I was curious about you, and now my curiosity is sated. Wait. You're not thinking of bringing feelings into this, are you?
Not.
What about love?
Love. We were ratting. It has nothing to do with love.
It's not always up to you. Love can be pretty persistent.
I don't care. It can go pester someone else. Did you know I was once married? When I was freed, I swore I would never marry again.
Aww.
I know you don't want to be tied down. And I would never do that to you.
Good. I appreciate it. Now, if you're done trying to confuse the issue, I'm going to go.
Well, well. Yay, 10 points! Woohoo! That wasn't worth at least 25. Anyway, so yeah, we've got some stuff in the packs. We got a mage pack, a rogue pack, and a warrior pack. So we're gonna inventory full. What? Oh. Crap. I got a bunch of stuff I gotta put. Alright, so, well. Anyways, so yeah, I'm gonna get that situated, and then I will cut to the next part of our lovely fun times. Alright, we're back. I edited out all the funny, funky parts that I needed to do. So now we are continuing on, and I've got new armor. Yay, hopefully not this one. This one's not so dark. I would have better armor,
so I hear,
but
you think mages
this is the
should
one
be
that
free.
I can wear.
Everyone should be free, not just mages.
Not everyone's dangerous.
It's not about who's dangerous. It's about having choices made for you. Don't you wish you had the choice not to have lyrium stuck under your skin?
I do.
This is silly. I don't want to argue.
Do you want to guess what color my underclothes are?
Oh, yes. That's much more fun.
All right, Emmerich.
Hello, Emmerich. The guard captain says you're still chasing disappearing acts.
That's not funny. I need your help urgently. I've spent the past few years continuing my investigation into the murders of Nanette, Marin, and the other women. I believe I finally have a suspect. A man called Gascard Dupuis.
What?
Dupuy. That's a funny name.
It's Olesian. I believe he is descended from nobility. When I became convinced of his guilt, I went to the city guard and demanded that they do something. The guards raided his mansion and found nothing. They were forced to apologize, and I was reprimanded. Meredith forbade me from continuing my investigation, but she didn't say I couldn't seek outside help.
And I'm supposed to be the outside help.
My hands are tied. I can't do this on my own. What if one of the women who died was someone you loved? If Gaspard Dupuy is guilty, he must be stopped before he kills again. We have to try.
Why is it always Hawk to the rescue?
I can't really answer that. You'll need to go to Gaspard Dupuy's estate after nightfall. Please figure out what Dupuy is hiding. If he's innocent, find evidence to prove me wrong.
Oh, all right.
It's just that simple.
It's not that simple. I have to fight stuff, and I have to jump through hoops, and blah, blah, blah. All right, let's find out what next we can do. No, I think we've got most of the quests that we need to do under wraps. Now we just have to pick which ones we want to do. Black Parade of Courtesy, Prime Suspect. Repentance of Sebastian's. Oh, and Night Terrors. Yeah, let's do this one first. Alright, here we are, Arani. What you need?
I was hoping you'd come. You did so much for my Fainreal already, but...
But?
I visited him among the people, but he turned me away. I know the demons still plague him. And now they've taken him. 2 days ago, Fainreal went into a nightmare and hasn't returned.
So you're, what, hoping I can yell really loudly in his ear, maybe give him a good shake?
I'm hoping you can reach him. You made a strong impression when you rescued him from the slavers. My Dalish friends tell me he speaks of you all the time.
Aww.
The Keeper says Fainreal's powers are a throwback to ancient magics that once let elves shape the Fade. The only way to reach him is through his dreams.
What?
Well, all right. I could use a map.
Keeper Marathari thinks an ancient Dalish ritual can help free Fainreal, but someone he trusts must enter the Fade to guide him out. Are you willing to submit to her magic to save my son?
I don't know. What do I have to do?
What does the ritual entail?
The Keeper can explain it better than I. Her ritual will send you into the Fade. Once there, I imagine you face down the demons until Fainreal regains control of himself. You will be unable to return from the Fade until he does.
Okay.
I've made worse deals.
The Fade is a place for mages, not for people like you and I.
Oh, what the heck?
I've already called for the Keeper. We need to begin the ritual as quickly as possible. Would you like to stay here or return when she arrives?
I can do it.
This is too urgent to delay.
You have been far kinder than I had any right to expect.
I came quickly, Ariane. I did not wish to tell you by letter how grave your son's situation is. The magic he possesses makes him what the Tevinters called Somniari, a dreamer. Dreamers have the power to control the beyond, what humans call the Fade. Fainreal is the first in 2 ages to survive.
Well, let's do it.
Just send me into the Fade.
I told you he was amazing.
Now, Ariane, please excuse us. We must prepare.
Oh, of course.
There is more I must tell you that is not for her.
This is not real.
You're really not.
This is a serious matter. Fainreal cannot become an abomination. The destruction he would cause is unimaginable. If you cannot save him from the demons, you must kill him yourself.
Oh, jeez.
A death in the Fade will make him what your circle calls tranquil. He will be no threat after.
All right.
I will not let him become a danger.
I wish you luck.
Thanks.
Now, gather a team, and we will begin. Choose carefully, for all will face temptation.
Oh, boy.
I never give in to temptation.
You're right.
I have no desire to explore the Fade, but if you need me, I will go.
I admit, I'm a little fascinated.
Let us begin.
Okay, let's do... Fainreal, alright, let's clear the plate. Anders, I want you. I want you, Anders. Isabella, of course. And... yeah, why not? Varric, you're curious, we'll take you along. There we go.
I had not thought to return in such a way. It is good to feel the breath of the Fade again, not the empty air of your world.
Aw, the glow is ruined. I wonder what happened. It must have been filling with mods or something. Eh, I'll fix it later. What's wrong with you?
Does that happen to every mage in the Fade?
I am Justice. Anders has told you of me. Come. I sense Fainreal's mind straining. We will not have much time.
Ah, alright, so that's all the time I have. Oh, now you're getting the blue... No, you're not. Yeah, you are. There's your blue glow. Well, that was weird. Wait, zoom in. Is it glowing? Yeah, now you're glowing. Why did you not glow last time? Whatever, Anders. Big poopy face. Okay, well, I gotta pause it here. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. And we will resume on the next one. Bye!